Father, we thank you for this time. Thank you for the opportunity, Father God, to stand here. Father God, be touched by the presence of God. We pray, Lord God, by the power of your Holy Spirit, that you will minister to every person, to every individual, Father God, that is listening, Father God, to this broadcast this afternoon. In the name of Jesus, I pray for the power of God to be unleashed, Father God, in this meeting this afternoon. Touch every heart, soften every attitude towards you, Father God. I pray, Father God, hallelujah, that you will manifest your healing power, your saving power, your deliverance power in this place. Lord God, that your word will go out freely, Lord God, tonight, this afternoon, Father God. We thank you for it. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen and amen. Hallelujah. Thank you. You are released, choir. Thank you very much. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Sarimi nakanakalo. Hallelujah. Our text, our reading is from the book of Mark. Mark chapter 5. If you have your Bible with you, can you look or smartphone or whatever electronic devices that you've got, it's got a Bible app on it. Can you please look up Mark chapter 5? Mark chapter 5 from verse 25 to verse 29. A very famous story of a lady that theologians call, this lady is named Lydia. Praise the Lord. Mark 5 from verse 25 to verse 29. And the Bible says, now a certain woman had a flow of blood for 12 years and had suffered many things from many physicians. She had spent all that she had. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. And was no better, but rather grew worse. When she heard about Jesus, she came behind him in the crowd and touched his garment. For she said, if only I may touch his clothes, I shall be made well. Immediately the fountain of her blood was dried up, and she felt in her body that she was healed of the affliction. Here ends our reading. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. The title to this message is two hindrances or two blockages of coming to Christ. In this lesson, in this text, we find that this lady has been suffering from this condition for a very long time, 12 years to be exact. As each year passed by, she got worse and worse. Despite of all the visits to the doctors, to the specialists, all the tests she had to undergo, all the scans, all the MRIs, all the x-rays, all the injections and medicines she had to take, all the care and the attention of the medical professional, she didn't improve. Nothing could satisfactorily cure her condition. She kept getting worse and worse. She was progressively getting worse every year. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And away muni wai esikoma ela koma ela enraida kina namaramongo. Hallelujah. Esa toro so muti kuna na iwa tangi ni ngende ni nona mbula. Sega mga tuwa ni mbula minaka sanga idati kuna ama iwa kalemu. Ena bi ambaki tau doko. Me adoma mai na ikatini karua ni ambaki. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Maka mabati kuna dende. Suffering chikomai. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Leviticus chapter 17 verse 14. The Bible says that the life of all the flesh is in the blood. The life of all the flesh is in the blood. Can you imagine this lady for 12 long years bleeding, discharging blood, and life is being drained out of her all those years. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. The number one blockage of us coming to Christ, the number one blockage is self. The number one blockage is self. Okay, the Serena. Praise the Lord. This lady at one time was strong and healthy. Praise the Lord. She could go anywhere she wanted and do anything she wanted. She could travel around the world, go sightseeing to all the interesting places around the world. She could go to any event, concerts, Fiji Fashion, Hibiscus Festival, and of course the Tembara Festival. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. She could attend any function. She could go to weddings. She could go to birthday parties. She could go and watch any sporting event. Amen. She could go and watch sporting matches. And she could go to the Rugby World Cup, the South Pacific Games, the Battle of the Giant Games. She could do anything she wanted to. Praise the Lord. Ecclesiastes chapter 12 verse 1 says, remember your creator in the days of your youth. Monanumi koe kambuliiko, niko se daurabotiko. Hallelujah. You remember this lady here. For those 12 is the more tubi naka kina naronambula. Sena saranga nindua naka. Ebi naka tupa metakawa. Membaleta na lai lotu. Membaleta na lago bechisu. Nothing. Church was not factored in her life. Praise the Lord. There was no attempt whatsoever on her part to attend church. Church was not in her schedule. Church was not being considered as an option to go to. In her busy schedule, God was not included or considered. Namarama turun rambala bungo. Nangonai tubi naka kina nonambula. Senga saranga ni bela kogwa na kalou. Senga ni bela ilotu. Senga saranga ni bela ngaraba na kalou. Praise the Lord. It never entered into her mind that one day this life is coming to a stop or an end. Never did. She never considered it. Praise the Lord. In her attempt to pursue happiness and a better lifestyle, Almighty God was not even considered. Psalms 127 verse 1. Unless the Lord builds the house, they labor in vain who build it. Unless the Lord guards the city, the watchman stays awake in vain. Praise the Lord. My friend, you that are watching, you that are listening, praise the Lord. Life has no meaning. Life has no purpose. Life has no value without the Lord Jesus Christ in your life. Life is an empty vacuum without the Lord Jesus Christ. You can fill it up with drugs. You can fill it up with alcohol. You can fill it up with parties. You can fill it up with whatever you want to fill it up. But apart from the Lord Jesus Christ, life is an empty container. Amen. The blockage number two. Blockage number two is our success. Amen. This lady was seriously rich. Going to na marama pa kay tangi. Going to na marama pa kay labo. Going to na marama buto niyaw. This lady is a very wealthy lady. That's the reason she could afford to go to doctors. She is extremely successful. Within that successful life, God was not at the center of it. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Please hear this. Money will buy a bed, but not sleep. Money will buy books, but not brains. Money will buy food, but not an appetite. Money will buy finery, but not beauty. Money will buy a house, but not a home. Money will buy medicine, but not health. Money will buy luxury, but not culture. Money will buy amusements, but not happiness. Money will buy a crucifix, but not a savior. Money will buy religion, but not salvation. Money will buy the best life insurance policy, but it cannot buy you eternal life. Money will buy a good life, but not eternal life. Money will buy a passport to everywhere but heaven. Amen. Praise the Lord. Matthew 16. Verse 26, the Bible says, for what profit is it to a man if he gains the whole world and loses his own soul? Or what will a man give in exchange for his own soul? Ia kagawa na kena yang abuan at tamata, kaya kaya rawat yung bura-bura tau doko, kabagay liya na elona, sa edabay na sulia na tamata, may saw ni elona. In conclusion tonight, or this afternoon, are you preoccupied with the things of this life and neglected about Jesus Christ? Have you considered that one day this life is coming to an end and you are not going to take everything with you? What is stopping you from coming to Jesus Christ? Would you allow yourself or your success to prevent you from coming to the Lord Jesus Christ? Hallelujah. Suri tira tau chukana mata gin gin merto laga tega chiku mai. And I come in this single and I know a kangu. Keba kao iiko. O buka ronga kiko. And the Lord to come raki ongo. Hallelujah. Ke o buka tarra kiko. Estona kaino no mumbula. Me tata robini no mulaku mai wana kalo. Elo minaga desa apoyango na kena ngauna. Molesu kina be chisu. Malanduna singa. And the Bulangori and the Malumumai, Duna Sina, and the Beka Kele, and the Rena Timomo, and the Dab of Mai, Sedabatale of Atara, Sedabatale Timurano Mumbula, Kovatara Tico, Metata Romino Lava Mai Manakalo, now a Kango Vesure Tico, and a Kavi Boyni Sina Dendai, and the other Marai Chisu, Sequa Bagamona Kena Rominaka, Mosolia Kina and Mumbula Wanakalo. Hallelujah! Praise the Lord. Can do a war wrong at Tico. And a lot of Kamuraki on go. Kamandreva Mosulian and Omumbula Mechi Su. Labatanga and Lingam. Namunoma Davidik. And if anybody that is listening, hallelujah, at my voice at the moment, at this, the ministry of the Word of God, and you would like to give your heart to Jesus, you would like to give your life to Jesus, just lift your hands right where you are. Lift it up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You won't take anything where you're going. It'll be all left behind. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You're not coming to the preacher. You're not coming to the church. You're coming to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Paolo beta ta ke dalina mo na kami ni singongo. Hallelujah. O liu ta ke kenda indo na masu. Wakanda ta muria nga if you lift your hands up wherever you are. Hallelujah. I will lead you in a prayer. Just repeat after me as we pray right now. Dear God in heaven, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I have heard your word and I come to you repenting of all my sins. I ask you now, please forgive me for everything that I've done that have broken your heart. I confess to you all of my sins. I renounce the Satan and all his works from all areas of my life. Lord Jesus, come into my heart, be my Savior and be my Lord. Fill me with your Holy Spirit and power. I pray this prayer to the Father in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen and amen. Let me just pray for you, Father God. I thank you, Father God, for every person that have prayed that prayer. I pray, Lord God, that a mark that cannot be erased have been made in their heart of hearts. I pray for the transformation and the change, Lord God, of the Holy Ghost taking place in them right now, bringing them, Father God, to be in the likeness and in the image of the Lord Jesus Christ. We give you all the glory and the praise for it. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen and amen and amen and amen.